community groups or whatever, we need to do that because on average, what are the customers? 4 million a year each? That's a lot of money that we could be using on other things. So it's something that we need to really look at. We know it's been looked at before, but nobody has had the courage to actually do anything about it. We are at the point now where that courage is required by councils. You're looking to save money. I'm giving you some answers.
Sure. In response to Councillor Minister's question, and the answer is soon as it's yes, we are soon bringing forward again a budget option that we have rejected in the past. Because as Kevin said, and Mike said in their presentation, our aim, our aspiration, our desire, our wish is that we don't impact more frontline services at £45 million.
Technology, if the contractors buy what they need. thank you, Ted. Our key issues are tackling health inequalities and poverty, disadvantage, and protecting the vulnerable. Now, I class disabled people as being vulnerable, obviously. Now, I've just had a couple of instances recently where people do not have a disabled parking bay because they've got a front garden, and I just think it's absolutely disgusting that they have to pay, whether it's a social landlord, it's Magenta Limited, wherever, if they own it, they are not allowed to have a disabled parking bay. Where they've even been mapped out, measured out, and marked out on the street, and then they get told that you've got a front garden, you can have one, but it only costs like £3,000 or £4,000. There's no money. Now, to me, we should be, you know, protecting them. You talk about remaining independent living. We don't even give them a disabled day outside their own properties. It's disgraceful.
I think for you, Chair, at the moment, on things like disabled parking bays and HR parkings, there are dispensations in place for new badge holders. So I'm more than happy to clarify the precise policy outside of
the
meeting. We already have a scheme in place where there is, as I say, there is a dispensation for disabled people.
Thank you, Mark.
Thanks, Chair. Going back to the cross-person options, the charging income and collection making sure the council has effective and efficient processes collecting income. Does that include debt collection?
It will, but as we release this to this committee, it's about ensuring that things that we actually deliver on behalf of us, we actually charge and what it costs us to pay. The rule of service that we deliver to other organisations, which we make a calculation what to charge, and it's clear that what we charge is not what it costs. The only thing is that we do include the staff process, as opposed to then the pensions that allow our staff to pay. Because then things like the premises cost, the IT cost, the HR cost, the management cost, the premises cost, which we never include. So there are a number of areas where, particularly Mark's, where we've looked at what we charge for service that we did on behalf of the network process.
Yeah, just bringing it back to those questions up there for a second. I think it would be really useful to get other organisations, the sector, maybe housing, things like that, to come in and sort of help us. I imagine we can also quite need to, to help assess the impact, see if models like this have been before as well, so things like that, so we can get a gauge for how it will impact on the sort of like increase in the group. So I think that would be really useful. And I'd be happy to sort of do the workshop.
I agree with what Matt said. I thought people that
we've got a recommendation for.
Recommendation to be noted. Item 4, Liverpool City Combined Authority.
Thank you, Chair. Just a few words around this. The report is largely self-explanatory, so the idea here is to make sure that there are appropriate scrutiny arrangements in place around the work of planning authority, which obviously members are familiar with. Paragraph 2.2 of the report sets out the proposed constitution of the panel, which is essentially two elected members from the leading groups of each of the six constituent authorities, so that gives the 12 in total, and then one elected member from the Conservative group and the Liberal Democrat group at the Liverpool City Region level, giving us four people together. And I think just for completeness, Chair, the report refers to nominations by members being made at the council meeting on the 14th of July. I think obviously as members are aware in this meeting, I think we've got yourself, Chair, and Council of Leach, down as representatives from the Labour group, and I think as I understand Councillor John Hale as well from the Conservative group, and then I think based on the numbers, I think the representative from the Liberal Democrat group actually be from second council, if I understand that.
Absolutely.
Any questions?
How will you respond back to this committee? Will it be yourself?
Yes, I'm the link.
The designated link. So you'll be the one that we will be able to quiz on what to do in all of this.
That's my understanding, Dave.
Excellent. Thank you.
Go inside.
Go for me.
Yeah.
Would
the
next
training
set?
But after training set, alright. Yeah, just to clarify, Anita and I are waiting the date for when the training is going to be, and then we'll know more.
By officers or others
it's just been the process of going through the planning committee. So in terms of that particular indicator, we did make a number of other changes last year as well about the progress of the Section 106 agreements and things like that, which hopefully will mean that the indicator will be coloured green for this financial year.
I just like to make clear that our situation really is sort of by talking in the past tense in this report, because we've got a new panel at the planning committee now, and it's talked about past training in September. I think we should be looking at the future training in this report as well, because we have got future training and planning training.
Yes, we have that training scheduled for the 18th of August. So that will be a big one.
Okay, thank you, Chair. And actually, so that's very much about looking back in terms of the business planning process. In terms of looking forward then, importantly, from page 57 onwards, we've got Appendix 4, which is actually the Regeneration Environment Directorate Plan 2014-16. So that runs through from page 57 right through to page 85. I think obviously quite a sizable document there. The one thing that I would do, however, is on page 81, I draw members' attention to the performance outcomes framework. So one of the things that we're trying to do is actually capture all of the important aspects of the directorate plan in one place, on one page. So for members' assistance, that one pager there, that outcomes framework, right, page 81, is actually just a useful overview of that role that we've laid down on the corporate plan, the directorate plan, what we're trying to achieve, etc. And then just for completeness, from page 86 onwards, we've then got appendix 5. And that runs all the way through, it's probably about 50 odd pages there. So in terms of process for all of the key performance indicators under the directorate plan, we actually have a template which actually gives members a fairly significant amount of detail there around the performance indicators that we're working to within that plan. And I think just as a final point in terms of in the current year that we're in for completeness, Chair, the very last appendix there, appendix 7, that's essentially just the first quarter one performance outturn for April to June inclusive of the 14-15 year. And that's on page 143. And I think as members would hope, I'm pleased to confirm this at this stage, after quarter one, the right status of all those indicators, we are green and on target with all of those aspects.
Any questions? Lisa?
Just on page 86, you mentioned the Mr. Wirral guide, obviously, not particularly good, but just outline what Mr. Wirral is in some of the things.
What Wirral is
in? East Wirral.
Yeah. Through your chair, as part of the local sustainable transport fund initiative, where we've managed to secure significant funding via the Department of Transport, the key idea behind that fund was very much, particularly in the more deprived areas, actually linking people from those areas to jobs. So all of that area. It is exactly that. So it runs all the way from, certainly from the Birkenhead area, right down to Romburg and the industrial park and onwards. All the way down the A41 to the east side of that, taking us right down to all of those commercial industrial sites that are down there within those walls down east of Romburg.
So it's right the way down to the end.
Starting with Manchester Ship.
Just Christina?
Could I ask a question on the issue of information things like the bike to work scheme? As a member of the cycle board, I've noticed in the past that there's always seems to be a major plan on where cycle paths are put. So will cycle paths from now on be put in this kind of arrangement here?
For you, Chair, the one of the elements of LFDF is actually around capital investment in infrastructure. The cycle paths and infrastructure that we put in using this funding are very clearly targeted at key locations where we're trying to get people to particular employment sites or to public transport.
Can I just ask something that's a little bit confusing? If we take, say, the cycle path down the new causeway, is that discipline?
Through you, Chair, as I understand, that cycle path would be in and out of other funding that the council has to do over transport and the funds that we need this morning.
Right, so this is all centred off the end of the road.
I can remember that money. I was on that. It was such specific money, and they said if we didn't use it, I'm not even going away.
Well, if we didn't use it.
Yeah, if we didn't use it,
that's what I said. Just for clarity, so we've taken each year, we take thoughts on the transport capital programme through cabinet. We have the local transport plan programme, which is general measures to improve walking and cycling across the borough.
Yeah.
This was separate money, secured separately by emergency travel from the Department of Transport, specifically to get people in those deprived areas to key employment sites. So this is separate.
So
this,
take the same policy network, then you could use it for finishing off what has never been done on that cycle network. Is that the sort of thing we're talking about?
Through you, Chair, we'd have to look and just ensure that what we're proposing met the criteria of funding, which is linking the deprived areas to key public transport and employment sites. Having said that, if that wasn't the case, we do have a healthy cycling allocation through the LTP that we've used very extensively in areas such as Wallasey, particularly for the Wallasey network and with the support of Wirral Cycle.
Responds to the other occupation